Conversation at the Uganda-South Sudan border of Elegu, positive cases of COVID-19 have continued to rise. Now 23 cases have been registered at the Elegu border point alone in a span of 14 days. There is also about 160 cases in Amuru and Gulu, sparking fear of a second wave of the COVID-19 pandemic. Benson Ongom has a report.
Elegu border point at daytime, the entry and exit are barely guided by the COVID-19 SOPs, a likelihood of a bigger pandemic threat to the country.
This month alone, there are 23 positive cases coming from the border. They have been able to confirm to us that the number of COVID-19 each and every day is going up. But the biggest challenge that they are faced with, the people who test positive for COVID-19, there's nothing they can do with them. They have to advise them to go to their homes. But again, also they have said there's a huge challenge because to trace them is a big challenge. But the question of testing as well is one thing, because if you look at the border, how it is, just look at it.
The situation is worrying that people are tending to get relaxed in observing standard operating procedures, partly because the communities are mobile.
These are people who keeps moving each and every day. So when you're doing sensitization, it is always not definite that today you have met these categories of people, you have talked to them, tomorrow again you're seeing a new group of people coming in.
Along the borderline, we have not taken our step of going for community sample testing or random testing. We would get the scores of this infection within the border district like Amuru.
The new area we are now getting up, we are getting into is foci of infections in schools. Recently we had Gulu University with 17 students who actually had COVID. And then other smaller schools are cropping up, especially secondary schools.
Being at the border, what comes into the mind is the capacity of testing center, as many fluke their way into the country. This then raises the question of management of truck drivers and refugees coming to Uganda.
When you are found positive, they will just leave you to go, but only warning you that you are positive, have your certificate, go. You are positive because it is asymptomatic. But this is not what is enclosed in the community outreach strategy.
Last year at the peak, we had a big number of staff supported by Red Cross and other partners here. But now the staff base has reduced. So meaning enforcing compliance around the customs area here and then the community still remains challenging.
At Gulu Regional Referral Hospital, 9 patients are fighting for their lives at the intensive care unit, a situation that is daring for the medical personnel, according to Dr. Lima Jams, the director of the hospital.
2 very severe, 5 severe, and 2 mild, and they're the ones on oxygen. That is as of today. But we still also have people in community care or home-based care. But the unfortunate bit now is there's a lot of complacency. Is that okay? Our people tend not to care.
The home care treatment has become untraceable for the health teams from the border points, but even the few that the medics keep tabs on, a bigger threat the hospital and the health workers are worried of.
People have all gone to the effect of giving us wrong addresses, totally wrong addresses, to mislead the health worker. People have gone ahead and deliberately, instead of isolating themselves and staying where they are supposed to be isolated, gone into the community.
With numbers soaring and people declining to take the COVID-19 vaccination, there are calls on government to improve sensitization at the border points.
Our health workers, too, are not taking up the vaccines. Imagine out of the 500 people I have here, both health workers, clinical staff and non-clinical staff, that means the support staff, too. Only out of the 500, only 212 have taken the vaccine.
We need to do a massive testing right now. Because you see, our focus is on the travelers, but we are not testing majorly the community. So we don't know the in-depth in the community.